Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Fall Coral Lodge. We're excited this year that we're actually kicking off our year together in a joint concert with University Choir, University Chorale, and the University Chamber Singers. The group you see coming on stage is University Chorale. And we're very excited that this is the debut tonight for this ensemble, but also their conductor is brand new this year. We're so excited to welcome Professor Amy Karen, who's not only one of our cherished voice faculty, but now one of our esteemed choral faculty as well. As you know, she's been a member of the community and the greater Salesforce community for many years. We're so excited that she agreed to share her gifts with us in this way. So tonight's concert is When We Love. And without further ado, University Chorale, under the direction of Professor Amy Karen.
tonight. What a great crowd. These singers have dedicated so much time and effort to learning this music, and I'm really, really impressed with the sound that they've developed. And more importantly, I'm so impressed with the human beings that they are, the attitude that they bring to morale. I get constructive feedback and repertoire suggestions and affirmation pretty much at every rehearsal. So I'm very grateful and I'm very proud. The first song that we sang this evening, Count the Stars, was written by a friend of mine, Andy Beck. Andy shared with me the backstory about that song, so I would like to share it with you. A young man named Briggs Anderson lost his life in a boating accident when he was in high school, and his classmates, his choir mates, wanted to have a song to sing upon their graduation at their final choral concert in his honor. So they commissioned Andy through Alfred Publishing to write that song. In large part, Andy took that text from beautiful words that Briggs' mother spoke at his funeral, knowing that she would forever see her son in nature. So thank you for sharing that with us.
Oh. We're consisted of select members of the main university choir, and just for fun, we like to sing without a conductor. The first song we have for you tonight is an Italian madrigal called Si Che Vorrei Morire by late Renaissance composer Claudio Monteverdi. The song was first published in 1603 as a part of Monteverdi's fourth book of madrigals. And like all great madrigals, this song is about love. And if you speak any Italian, you will know exactly which kind of love it's about. Yes, let's just say the lyrics of this song are romantic. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
next song is a ballad called My Bonnie Lass, She Smiled, and was published in 1595 by English composer Thomas Morgan. The song features bouncy, dance-like rhythms, which helped to make it one of the most popular boogies of the late 90s. The late 1590s, mind you. Not the 1990s, no. This song came out then, I'm sure it would sound much different. Anyways, please enjoy this English classic.
Oh.
was not the Norwegian Alleluia. I actually switched the order up quite a bit tonight. When I wrote the program, we were talking about just the trajectory of the evening and where we wanted to start. And so this Aboriginal song, it seems to kind of speak to us in a way with what's going on in the world with Ukraine and Israel. And so just trying to think about what that must feel like. To be silenced in some way, where we're so fortunate, where we are here in the United States, that we always get to have our voices and we promote that and preach that. So that was Tormis's Aboriginal song. From there, we are going to go to prayer by Ryan Fawcett. And we had the privilege this week of having him on campus. Dr. Clausen is one of those people in the choral world who is legendary. He was at Concordia University or Concordia College in Moorhead, Minnesota for 35 years. And for people like me, we aspire to a career of that nature, have impacted just so many people in our field and so many singers with his music and with his conducting and with his teaching. And just to have the privilege of ever getting to sing for the concert themselves is amazing. And so we tried to take all of that in this week and watch him also work with about 350 high school students that were sitting in these chairs. And tried to learn something and bring this piece to life in a slightly different way. And what he told us about this, because you might have to help me, he wrote this one in an hour, and he found the prayer in a church bulletin when he happened to be sitting in a congregation one Sunday, and just the words really touched him, and so he decided that he would turn that into a piece of music. Pretty remarkable. So we hope you enjoy and have an opportunity to reflect tonight during this piece. Prayer.
Thank you.
love the title of our concert this evening. Is by Ian Hagenberg, who has sort of become one of the popular composers right now. And she kind of has a style. And often, her music is accompanied. And we just came across this little gem that happens to be a little bit more in our wheelhouse with being a completely a cappella program. It is sort of a piece this year, I would say, that we have one piece every year that is like our, our mantra or our flagship or what's the word I'm looking for? Our mission, I don't know. Anyway, it's this one. As I think about our, whenever we put programs together and our repertoire, the goal is always to take the audience on a bit of a journey of sorts. And so as you have the opportunity to just be in a chair and hopefully listen to some music that affects us here, and an opportunity to just sort of reflect and be in the space together. And so we hope that you enjoy what we love.
Oh, to leave you on the upside of life. Thank you so much for coming tonight, especially those of you who traveled from quite a distance. We really appreciate that, knowing that this is part of our work week. And we hope to see you at our next appearance with all the choirs once again at Candlelight in early December. So thank you so much for coming.